You understand what I'm saying? So I went on my way to make a language for us. It combines Syriac and Aramaic, and it's simple, real simple.
It is.
Anybody can learn it. But if you start it now, eventually these kids will be speaking their own language. Then you write stories about what took place in our time. Not about the Book of the Dead. It's nice to talk about Abraham, that's fine. But bring Abraham up to today. Tell your son great things your husband did. Not all the bad things he does. Tell him about the good times. How often do you discuss with your children the good things that you and your mate did? You don't. You always got them looking at television and seeing somebody else's good. Or reading the Bible and seeing someone else's dead story. Right. Try sitting down and tell your son great things about his father. And father, try to do great things so she'll have something to tell your son. Do you understand? Then we will no longer understand. We'll start overstanding. We'll be taking control of things again. And we will come alive. And that's what Jesus meant by, you must be born again. We were dead. We make no impressions in life. We have no art form. We don't even have music. And don't tell me hip-hop is music. You're talking to a person that produces music. Hip-hop is garbage. It's edits. It's bites. It's samples. It's not music. The nearest we got to music was blues. That's the nearest we got to music in this bondage was blues. And then it gravitated into jazz. And then it became just that. When John Coltrane and them got their hands on it, I'm talking about a proficient musician who decided to play what they call abstract jazz. It became just that, jazz. Something not worth listening to. And now we're nothing. We have no music. What is a nation of people without their own music? You women have got to invent a dance. I'm not talking about no monkey dance like you see on them hip-hop videos. All the monkeys on strings. Draw the strings on them one day and you'll see it. Empty hammer looks like one of them little things that they dangle like this. That's my brother, but truth is true. That boy's my mother, truth is true. Y'all got to invent dances. And your dances have to tell the stories of the things that happened to us. That we men got to play the music for the dances. And then we're giving birth to a culture. And then the word cult is no longer an insult. So father, when they say, oh, y'all belong to that cult, say, that's right. We are cultivating our culture. Yeah, we're a cult, all right. But what is a cult without any culture? You understand? Y'all were in Vails 2 years ago and miserable. But now that the veil is removed and the women are becoming a part of us, you follow? We're going to be twice as strong.
That's right.
We ain't going to be right-handed no more longer. We're going to be ambidextrous again. And stop suppressing them. That was necessary. Oh yeah, it was necessary. You know why? Because of the state of mind we were in when the veil came to us. We were a mess. We as women, I mean we like in you upside down me. We thought that we had to tighten our pants up and show our butt to be sexy. Didn't we? I'm talking about women, not men. Everything had to be seductive. Someone gave us the wrong outlook on life. So y'all had to be veiled. You understand that? To remove that. So it was a form of discipline. Because I seen a girl walking down 40 seconds. You know, like, you can't hold an intelligent conversation without women in tight pants walking by and distracting it. You can't study in school because the girl next to your blouse is too tight. All that's done purposely to keep us from having right thinking, pure thought. The veil was necessary, y'all. But now the veil is lifted. And the women have to take over. You know why y'all have to take over? I know you brothers ain't gonna like this. Because we don't do a good job. The world is in a mess. I mean, was Iran or Iraq destroyed by women?
No.
No, it was destroyed by men because of men. The Shah was a man. Ayatollah's a man. Bush, Reagan, or Contras, the Watergate. every scandal was women in the laboratory experimenting around with the bacteria that made AIDS on men. When we liberate our women, we're going to be in power. You understand that? They know if they take our woman from us, they take our strength. I'm telling you, brothers, you will be surprised if you really sat down and gave your wife the right to talk. How intelligent she can be. But you ain't going to do that. You're afraid of her. Right. Y'all better wake up.
I just want to ask a question. Who really cares? Save a world in despair. Who really cares? There'll come a time.
There'll come a time
when the world won't be singing.
When the world won't be singing.
Flowers won't grow.
Flowers won't grow. No.
Bells won't be ringing.
No bells won't be ringing.
Who really cares?
Who really cares?
Who's willing to try?
Who is willing to try?
To save a world.
To save a world.
That's destined to
that
die.
That is destined to die.
When I look at the world.
When I look at the world.
It fills me with sorrow.
It fills me with sorrow.
Little children today.
Children today.
Really gonna suffer tomorrow.
Really suffer tomorrow.
Oh, what a shame.
What a shame.
Such a bad way to live.
Such a bad way to live.
Who is to blame?
Who is to blame?
We can't stop
when
living.
We can't stop living. Oh, oh.
Live.
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 Live for life. Life.
But let live, everybody.
Live life for the children.
Live.
Let's save the children. Let's save all the children.
Save.